A second bridge crossing from Detroit to Canada is formally announced. It's set to bring thousands of jobs, and officials claim taxpayers won't pay a thing for it.
We have Team 7 coverage of the announcement. We have reporters in Detroit and Canada, and we will talk to Governor Rick Snyder live in just a moment.
Let's begin with 7 Action News reporter Michael Rosenfield in Canada with what happened across the border today. Good evening, Michael.
A monumental day for our friends here in Canada and back home right across the border in Michigan. It's been years in the making, but now a second bridge between Detroit and Windsor is a go.
I do a lot of announcements, as you know, but this is a really big one.
Canada's Prime Minister Stephen Harper, along with Michigan Governor Rick Snyder and U.S. Secretary of Transportation Ray LaHood, announcing today in Windsor a second bridge will be built.
It's a big deal for both of our countries, but it's a particularly big deal for people who want to go to work, for people who are bridge builders, for people who know how to build roads, for people who need a job.
About 10,000 construction jobs on the Michigan side are expected to be created, with the new bridge not only leading to more jobs, but to an increase in business investment on both sides of the border and improved traffic flow. The bridge will link I-75 and I-94 with Highway 401 in Ontario, avoiding traffic tie-ups in downtown Windsor. And officials say Michigan taxpayers won't have to pay. Canada will fork over Michigan's share of the project, some $550 million, and all tolls will go to Canada to repay the debt.
We weren't in a position to do this, and because of the thoughtfulness and generosity of our partners, they're reaching out to help us.
Canada has already started work on its access roads for the project. It's unclear when exactly groundbreaking will take place on the Michigan side, but once construction begins, it will take 4 to 5 years to complete the bridge. In Windsor, Michael Rosenfield, 7 Action News.
Our coverage continues now at Cobo Center.
That's where key leaders in the push to get the bridge met and made it official. 7 Action News reporter Smita Koloki is there now to continue our developing story. Smita, they came to Cobo to sign and to celebrate that big deal.
Oh, they sure did, Joanne. You know, I don't think that moment was lost on anybody here. The room erupted in applause the second they had signed the papers, before the ink was even dry on that paper itself. Now, again, Governor Rick Snyder and Prime Minister Stephen Harper here at Cobo Center to sign that deal, make it official. Now, it marks months of planning by the administration, but years for Michigan. They were also joined by U.S. Transportation Secretary Ray LaHood, who said it was a sign of the strong bond between the U.S. and Canada. Now, Canada is Michigan's largest trade partner, which last year shared $70 billion in two-way trade. Not everyone is happy with this deal. Outside Cobo Center, protesters on both sides of the issue took stand. Members of the Delray community were worried about their neighborhood, but other protesters standing right next to them say it is about bringing jobs and bringing them here to Michigan. Now, back here live, they did have a meeting with the Delray community and Lieutenant Governor Brian Kelly. We understand that, according to the Delray community members, some of their concerns were eased, but clearly not enough to keep them from coming here and protesting. From Cobo Hall, Smita Koloki, 7 Action News.
All right, Smita, thank you very much. And Governor Rick Snyder joins us now live from Detroit to talk about this.
Good evening, Governor. Thank you so much for being with us. This is
Good
a
evening.
Big day for you, Governor. It's been a long road. And what is it, Governor, about this bridge that's so important to you that you were willing to go around the state legislature to get the deal done?
Well, I didn't go around the state legislature. They didn't want to participate in this process, so we did it through the executive office authorities. And the real issue to do it is more and better jobs. We need more and better jobs in Michigan, and this trade crossing is an outstanding opportunity. In the short term, it could be 10,000 jobs over the next few years, and longer term, it's even more important because we do about $70 billion a year in trade with Canada right now. That's more than the next 25 countries combined. And one of the bottlenecks are crossings to Canada. We already have the busiest one in North America right here in Detroit, Windsor. Let's get a new crossing going. Let's generate more trades and let's generate more and better jobs for Michiganders. It's really exciting.
Governor, I wonder, you know, you have always been a huge fan and pushed hard for free enterprise. As you know, the bridge, the Ambassador Bridge, been owned privately for years. Why do you feel that the public sector should get involved with this second bridge and not let the private sector do it?
Well, most bridges are built by the public sector. I mean, it's a rare difference in terms of the Ambassador Bridge. 99-some% of all bridges are owned by the public sector. The other part that's good and interesting in this project is the bridge here will actually be built by a private concessionaire. A private party will come in and build and finance the bridge that will be repaid from tolls for the new bridge.
You may have been able to hear Smita Koloki's report. She mentioned some concerns among Delray residents, right, about having this construction in their neighborhood and whatnot. State Representative Rashida Tlaib, who represents the Delray community, said in a statement that she actually believes that Detroit should hold off selling the more than 70% of land owned by the city that will be used for the project until promises are fulfilled. Things like keeping trucks out of the neighborhoods, air quality, health protections, things like that. What can you, as their governor, say to them to assure them in that community that this is a good thing for them as well?
Yeah, well, we've been successful in the past with projects to do community benefits. And one thing we're looking for and learning from is we're looking to the Canadians. So part of our agreement is to look how they're doing community benefits for the Windsor Essex Parkway, which is a project coming along that has similar issues in terms of people in the neighborhood, how to best deal with those issues, how to look at getting jobs to people in the neighborhood and creating more opportunity for growth in a great community area. So in many respects, we're learning from the Canadians. They've got a good model. We've got a good model in the past, and so we are focused on giving community benefits to people in Delray, southwestern Detroit, and Detroit.
Well, Governor, some Michigan lawmakers were concerned you would use the Michigan Strategic Fund to get a deal done, and they were trying to prevent that. Is that happening?
Well, if you go to the whole question, we are not using Michigan taxpayer dollars for this project. And that's the main point. And that's why I was able to do it through the executive office. Since it didn't require an appropriation of taxpayer dollars, it didn't require the legislature being involved. Because they're my partner. I appreciate their role. But given the circumstance and how we're arranging this with no obligation to Michigan taxpayers, we could move forward because it's about jobs. And I would hope more and better jobs is a top issue for every Michigander because it's a great opportunity.
You know, Governor, I wonder, there's been great opposition by Maddie Maroon and the group, the People Should Decide ballot initiative, right, seeking to require government proposals to build additional international crossings in Michigan be approved by the voters first. Can you tell us where that stands now? Is there anything that they can do or bring that ballot up for a vote that would affect what happened here today?
Well, in terms of, we're in a crisis. We still have too much unemployment in Michigan. It's still over 8%. And the way I view it is we've come down from 14%, but 8% is not good enough. We need to keep moving, and there's no reason to wait. And one of the keys to our long-term future for job creation is getting this new crossing. So let's move forward with it. Let's get it going. Again, I always respect what goes on the ballot, but there's an urgency here to say, don't people want more and better jobs in Michigan? This is one of the best ways to do it. And so let's get going and build a great bridge.
Well, Governor, what's the timeline for that? When can we expect to cross this great bridge?
Yeah, we do have some next steps in terms of permits. So the next step is to go get a presidential permit from Washington and also some Coast Guard permits. And I think we'll be doing that fairly quickly. We'll be applying in the next week or two for those permits. And then as they get issued, then the real process will get started, which will take several years. So it's about a 4-year to 5-year process. But again, given the time lag and the need for jobs, there's no reason to wait. So I'm looking forward to pushing this project ahead in dog years as quickly as we can.
Well, I know you've been working on it for a number of years already, Governor, trying to get this done. So we thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us tonight. We appreciate it very much.
Thank you, Governor.
Great to be with you.